This is Truck 1 to BabelColour.
This is Truck 1 to BabelColour. My name is John Levine, and I was Unit Sergeant Benton. And I actually subscribe to BabelColour, and I need to make sure that Stuart has got this message to let the people know BabelColour is fantastic. Sergeant Benton signing off. Goodbye.
Hello, my name is Clayton Hickman, and I'm a big fan of BabelColour, and I think we're very lucky to have Stuart doing such beautiful things with such beautiful old clips.
The tributes he makes are just absolutely wonderful.
I think BabelColour bridges a divide between production and fandom, providing for excellent fan fiction.
There's just something about the Ten Doctors that makes it this perfect blend of both classic and new Doctor Who.
The Ten Doctors impressed me so much.
I'm John Guiler from Day of the Doctor. And I'm subscribed to BabelColour. Yes, you should subscribe now.
My name's Jonathan Carley, and I've played the Doctor.
The Daleks!
And various other robots in almost a dozen BabelColour videos.
And I'm very lucky, every now and again, to be able to work with one of my heroes.
BabelColour's my hero. His magic shines like fire and ice.
To me, colour is life. So when BabelColour works as magic, he literally brings these old relics back to life for me, and I'm able to enjoy them much, much more.
I'm Steve Foreman, and I thrashed BabelColour on Goldmaster.
I'm David J. Howe, and I've really enjoyed BabelColour's work. If you want colour, get BabelColour.
BabelColour's videos never cease to amaze me. The work, the time, the love that he puts into everything that he does.
Hello, this is actor Nathan Head. You may not remember me from the 2007 Christmas special Voyage of the Damned, but I've been a long-time subscriber to BabelColour, and when Liz Sladen died, he put together a fantastic tribute video called Tears for Sarah Jane, and even to this day I can't watch it without shedding a tear.
BabelColour's videos always provoke an emotional response, from awe at seeing rediscovered footage seamlessly integrated with black and white and colour, through to weeping at his excellent tribute videos.
The Doctor Who Misinformation Guide was, and still is, one of the best tools to use if you want to know more about the origins of Doctor Who.
My first video was every Doctor Who story, and now every time I hear the music, I think of that video.
BabelColour is the best advert for Doctor Who that the BBC never employed.
I'm Matt Karajan. I'm basically a fan-turned-collaborator. I've worked on a few BabelColour videos, and has really given my appreciation a new colour.
True Colours is my favourite video. It's wonderful to view these vintage shots brought to life by the hours of painstaking work and attention to detail that Stuart devotes to them.
I credit my success at Doctor Who Trivia mostly to BabelColour because I binged-watched his videos.
I love his videos. I think BabelColour rules my universe.
Unfortunately, some of my very earliest videos are missing from the Babel archives, so if you have copies of any of them, then please get in touch and plug those gaps.
I've been watching BabelColour's videos since the very early days of YouTube, and his content's always been fantastic, and his colourisations have been beyond amazing.
I've been watching videos by BabelColour for as long as I've been a Doctor Who fan. As a kid, I was particularly impressed by his colourisation videos, because I got to see all the stuff from the 60s in a whole new light.
BabelColour's Fifth Doctor tribute introduced me to The Kinks, one of my absolute favourite bands.
I'm Tom Spilsbury, the former editor of Doctor Who magazine, and I'd like to wish a very happy 11th anniversary to BabelColour, and here's to many more fantastic videos.
Even as a young Babelfish, colourising telesnaps, one could see Stuart's future greatness as BabelColour.
Hello, Crystal D here, wishing BabelColour a very happy 11th birthday. We love your work at the fan show, so please keep creating.
Hello, I'm Stephen Moffat. Thank you, Stuart, for your amazing work. Those colorizations and those enhancements are beautiful, impeccable, gorgeous work, and genuinely among my favorite things on the internet. Hello, I'm Stephen Moffat, and like a lot of unemployed and largely forgotten people, I spend most of my day crying. And on the internet. And crying. Now, as you know, the internet is mostly about, well, videos. Videos of cats being funny and really fit people injuring themselves, which is kind of my favourite. I can't get enough of people who are much fitter and better looking than me injuring themselves doing epic stunts. That's awesome. I think we could just take some of those parkour people and drive them off a cliff and see what they do. That would be... No, actually, I'm drifting, and that was profoundly unpleasant. My favourite thing of all, like most right-thinking Doctor Who fans, to watch on the internet is BabelColour. Because it demonstrates, aside from its virtuosity and its beauty, thanks to Stuart, it demonstrates something that is absolutely unique about Doctor Who. Lots of shows have a great future. Lots of shows. Doctor Who has an amazing future, and I've seen part of it. I've seen Jodie's first scene as the Doctor, and trust me, we are in for a thrill ride. She is already brilliant in such a tiny moment. She's given us the Doctor we've always known, but in, to say the least, a brand new way. We are in for a very exciting run. Doctor Who has an exciting present, because we're still working on the Christmas present that is, that was a very bad joke, wasn't it? That is the Christmas special, where David Bradley returns as the first Doctor and exquisitely recreates William Hartnell's wonderful performance from all those years ago, a recreation of such beauty and precision that it would be worthy of BabelColour itself. And of course, you're Peter Capaldi in his very last go as the Doctor, who's going to break your heart. Your heart is going to be in pieces by the end of this. Only Jodie Whittaker will be able to cheer you up again. He is astonishing. So you've got all that to come. But the amazing thing about Doctor Who is that, thanks to people like Stuart, the past is still happening. The past is still going on. With those colorizations and those enhancements, he's not just shown us old footage of old shows. He's made it feel like now. He's made it feel like it felt then. Because back then it was now. It is beautiful, impeccable, gorgeous work. And genuinely among my favorite things on the internet, especially as I have absolutely nothing to do at all. And you probably don't even remember who I am. But leaving us that terrible personal tragedy aside, Stuart, you're a master, you're a craftsman. Look what Stuart's done to Cardiff Bay. Look at that. Isn't that, you'd hardly recognize it. Look at that digital recreation of Cardiff Bay, improved forever. So thank you, Stuart, for your amazing work. And I will continue to watch. I've been on this show so long, I think my early shows only now exist as telesnaps. So if you could maybe recreate some of them, and I'm sure improve them. Happy anniversary. I hope to see you soon.
What I like about BabelColour is all the creativity and originality that goes into each production.
My favorite style of BabelColours are What About Everything and The Noblest Robot.
One of the first videos I ever saw on YouTube, if not the first, was one of his colorizations, and I remember it so clearly. Seeing black and white Doctor Who in photorealistic color was nothing short of magical.
BabelColour videos do really make it all feel like the one show that it is. You don't sense that divide between the classic and new series. It just reminds you, you're watching one big, beautiful, ridiculous show.
Thanks, Stuart. You're awesome.